My name is Ensieh Hosseini. I'm a researcher in the University of Glasgow. And today I'm talking about bioorganic glycine based flexible piezoelectric stress sensor for wound monitoring. In this presentation, first of all, we'll talk about our motivation, why we are interested in monitoring the pressure under the wound bandage. Then I will talk why glycine is an interesting case to use as a piezoelectric material. And then I talk about the growth of glycine crystal and then fabrication and characterization of glycine-based piezoelectric stress sensor. And finally, conclusion and future direction. It's known from the literature that the mechanical stress and electrical field can accelerate wound healing by improving the cellular proliferation. And currently, the compression bandages are designed to produce a sub-bandage pressure on the wound. However, this sub-bandage pressure may vary significantly, depend on the area of the body that this bandage is applied and to the elastomeric properties of the bandage. During the movement of the patient, this pressure will change significantly. And excess stress not only will not accelerate wound healing, but can delay wound healing due to some tears in the tissue or the vessels. In this case, monitoring the pressure applied under the bandage on the wound is important. And with this, we can monitor how much pressure is needed for each wound and how it can have effect on improving the wound healing. So in this case, the integration of a flexible, biocompatible, and ideally self-powered stress sensor with a wound dressing that can continuously monitor the pressure can solve this problem. Currently, there are, I can say the piezoelectric material are the ideal case to use as a sensor for this case, because as I said, not only pressure is important for the wound healing, but it's very well known that the electrical field also can accelerate wound healing. In this case, piezoelectric material can be used as a sensor, and also the produced voltage by them, it can help to accelerate wound healing. And among different non-piezoelectric materials, some of them like PCT that have the toxic element that cannot be used for this purpose, or some others also the biocompatibility is not fully approved, and also they need high processing temperature and they need a poly. But in recently, some bioorganic materials such as protein, amino acids, DNA, and cellulose, they have explored that they have piezoelectric properties, and they are a very good case to use in this condition. Although they have the level of piezoelectric signal in them is less than inorganic material, but they have some other advantages such as biocompatibility, biodegradability, low cost, and simple low temperature processing technique. Among different these bioorganic piezoelectric materials, I'm working on the glycine because glycine has a significant piezoelectricity at room temperature, and this crystal after growth doesn't need any poly. Means the crystallization and the use as a piezo material is very easy. Glycine is a simplest amino acid. It can be crystallized in three different polymorphic forms, alpha, beta, and gamma. And among them, only beta and gamma phase are piezoelectric, but alpha is not. So it's important in the growth to grow the piezoelectric phases. And about the, just very short, I said about the mechanism of piezoelectricity in this material are different with inorganic. In the crystal structure, we have the glycine molecules as a zeolite ion. They are connected together by is it and they are connected together by hydrogen bond, and each glycine molecule has a dipole moment. And piezoelectricity in this structure comes from the assumption of this dipole moment. And when we have a stress or pressure on the sample, this molecule is a little bit changed from this equilibrium position, and they can have a net polarization and a piezo response. Then in the first step, I grew glycine crystals from solution by mixing glycine and lithium nitride in the water, and then evaporation in the almost constant temperature to crystal grow under a slow evaporation. In this technique, the lithium nitride doesn't go inside the crystal, it just stays as a free ion in the solution, and it has just effect on the nucleation and the kinetic of the crystal growth. And then it just helps this crystal grow in the piezoelectric phase, in this case, which is gamma phase. And then after we had such a big crystals, then I grind up these crystals to the powder, and I made the extra diffraction on them. And it shows that the crystals were purely a gamma phase because the position of the peak was fully agreement with the literature data that we have. And then it was a fully piezoelectric phase of glycine. So since this crystal was not flexible to use as a sensor for the wound, then we decided to make something like a composite, similar composite, of them with the PDMS. For this, first I deposit a 100 nanometer gold on the PI substrate as a flexible substrate. Then I fixed this substrate on my glass for easy spin coating. Then I put a layer of very, very thin PDMS on the gold. And then we put a very small crystal of gamma glycine and very closely packed together on the surface. And I should say, before putting crystal, we cured the PDMS. And then we put another layer of the PDMS on that. And then again, this layer cured, and then repeat this process two times. It means like two layers of glycine crystals are embedded in the PDMS. And in order to have the better contact of this top layer of PDMS with the electrode, I've done exactly the same procedure in the other electrode. Two layers of the glycine and PDMS in this. And then while the PDMS and the top layer was partially cured, we attached them together. And finally, we had like these structures, like a four layer of small glycine crystal embedded in PDMS. And they are in a two gold, like sandwich structure between the two gold electrodes. And this final sensor has a very flexible structure. It's like a film, just less than, I would say, a few micrometer thickness. And this put like this PDMS with glycine is act like a composite and has a dielectric properties. And then we use the impedance spectroscopy analysis to see how is the impedance change with the frequency. It shows below 2 kilohertz, it has a capacitive structure, the impedance decrease, and the phase angle was about 90 degrees, and the capacitance at room temperature without applying any pressure was about 58 picofarad. In order to evaluate the piezoelectric signal of the sample, we just manually press the sample, and it shows it, and under each press and release, it has a periodic signal up and down with press and release, and this the sample has a fast response, which is good for the dynamic vibration that we have, and also then we characterize it how is the sensitivity of the sample. With different forces, it has a sensitivity of about 54 millivolt per newton. And then we applied how much current, we obtained how much current it's produced. Under pressure, it was about 10-15 nanoampere. And from this, we calculate the power density of the device. Although the power is low, is a nanowatt, it still is not good to use as a self-power sensor. But there are some ways to improve this, and we are not just in the first step of the material and fabrication. And one of our goals is to replace the PDMS that we use with some fully biocompatible and biodegradable polymer, such as silk and chitosan. And the interesting point is that the chitosan is already using as a bandage in wound healing, and it's known that chitosan has antibacterial properties. In some new works, we just could grow a glycine crystal directly inside chitosan, because chitosan is a water-based polymer. And then we have a film of the glycine and chitosan, which had even a stronger piezoelectricity than relative to the PDMS and glycine. I didn't bring the detail of the result here because it's not completed yet, but this is a future direction of our work, to have a completely biocompatible, biodegradable piezoelectric sensor. And with this, I would like to conclude this work here. We show for the first time the use of biodegradable piezoelectric glycine for flexible stress sensor. The fabricated device is flexible and has suitable for possible use as a sub-bandage stress monitoring, and also might be the produced voltage can accelerate wound healing, because it's now the voltage that is need to accelerate wound healing is in the very low, is like 100 millivolt would be enough. And also this stress sensor shows a repeatable signal and power generation under the compression. And as I said, our future direction is to replace PDMS with some biodegradable polymer. And of course, we have to put this sensor under compression, is a commercial available compression bandage, and see how it's real. And first of all, we put in the healthy subject, and then might be in the patient and see how it will react. Thank you.